Hello everyone, this is Pedram, and in this video, I want to talk about Google Colab. Google Collaboratory, or Colab for short, is a product from Google Research which enables you to write and run your Python code through the web browser. So all you need is to have an internet connection and access to a web browser, then you can run your Python code on it. The reason that I wanted to talk about Google Colab in this video is that I'm developing multiple new courses in deep learning and machine learning at university, which requires computation powers and it needs to be run on GPUs. And Google Colab will give you free access to those GPUs, of course, with some limitations. However, for my courses, the free tier is enough. So Colab is basically combined services from Google Drive, Python, Jupyter Notebook and GitHub, and it requires no setup to use, and that's what makes it super useful and convenient. So without further ado, let's jump into it. All right, let's go ahead and open a browser. So I personally use Google Chrome, but be aware that Colab can be run on any kind of browser. So let's go ahead and search Google Colab, and the first link, colab.research.google.com, should get you to the right page. Okay, so right now I'm not connected or I'm not signed into my Google Drive, and this is what you will see. And if you work with Jupyter Notebook before, this should look very familiar, right? We have a combination of text cells, Python cells, and we can write them together in a nice notebook, right? So the menus here are pretty straightforward. I want you to go ahead and explore them. For example, what you see in the file, edit, view, insert, runtime, and etc. Right? An important thing here is that right now, the notebook is not connected to any kind of server because I see the connect button here. I can push it, right? So when I go ahead and connect it to a server, now there's going to be a virtual machine assigned to me. But if I want to do that, I have to sign into my Google Drive first, right? So let's go ahead and sign in. I'm going to use my tutorial account. And as I said, when you're signed into your Google Drive, you'll see something like this. You can go ahead and close it. And right now I can click connect. So now it's allocating a virtual machine to me. Sometimes it's going to, depending on your internet connection and your location, it's going to take some time, right? So right now I see that I have been dedicated some space and some RAM, right? So this means that I can go ahead and run these cells. So the shortcuts are pretty much the same as Jupyter Notebook. So I'm not going to repeat them here, but if you're not familiar with Jupyter Notebook shortcuts, so please feel free to watch my other recordings when I talk about Jupyter Notebooks, or just simply Google it. So basically, if you click on any cell, if you want to run it, you can do Shift Enter. Or if it is a Python cell, you can press this play button or shift enter or control enter if you want to go to the next one, or alt enter if you want to run it and make a new cell, right? So for example, I can go ahead and run this cell. So it's going to say, go ahead and calculate this, put it in an object and then print that object. So this is pretty much the same as Jupyter Notebook, right? And one thing that I want to emphasize here is that right now, you have been dedicated a very simple CPU. If you want to run your code on a more powerful machine, you have to go ahead in the runtime and change the runtime type. And again, right now, it's basically a simple CPU. You can change it to GPU or TPU, right? So for depending on what wire you're using the notebook, if it is a very simple calculation, you can just leave it as none. But if you're doing some neural networks, you want to train the models, you want to be dedicated GPU, you can go ahead and set it to GPU. For as of now, I just run it, save it as none, because we're not in this tutorial, we're not going to use GPUs, right? Okay, so let's go ahead. So instead of working, so feel free to go over this documentation, which is available on the Google Colab webpage, or you can read more documentation here. But for the purpose of this presentation, I put together a file which is called Google Colab Jumpstart, and we want to open that here. Okay, let's go ahead and open that, open a notebook. And as you can see, I can get access to the examples which are already provided in Google, or I can open a Google Drive, or I can just search a GitHub public repository. So I want you to go ahead and search my username, pjalgotrader, and then press enter. So these are all my publicly available repositories that I have. And in order to access to that Jumpstart file, go ahead and click on Machine Learning USU. There are multiple branches that I have. So let's go to the fall 2022 and then scroll down to find the right files, which is Google Colab Jumpstart. By the time that you're watching this recording, there might be lots of more notebooks. So just make sure that you open the right one. So it's called Google Colab Jumpstart. So we have to go ahead and open this up. Okay, so this is a notebook that I want to go over with you. So, but before we can make any edit to this notebook, we have to make a copy to our own drive. Because let me give you an example. Imagine if I want to change, make a change to any of these cells. Let's say I want to make a change here, right? Call it, this is a test. Of course I can run it. If I do shift enter, it can be run. But the problem is that if I want to save it, you'll get an error. It says that you cannot save changes because you do not have permission to this, to save this notebook. So what you want to do is to make a copy of this notebook on your own drive. So before, let me show you something. If I go to my Google Drive, for this Google account, there's basically no folder here. There's just one, there's one folder called PJ Projects, right? I'm going to go ahead and make a copy of this notebook to my Google Drive, right? So, and the way to do that is go to File and basically save a copy in Drive, right? And now it's creating a copy of this notebook to my Google Drive. Now, if I go back to my Google Drive, there should be a new folder there. Okay, this new folder has been generated and it's called Colab Notebooks. And all the notebooks that I copy from different resources are gonna be saved up here, okay? So for example, look at the name. It's called Copy of Google Colab Jumpstart. You can go ahead and change the name, or you can leave it like this to just remind you that this is a copy of the original version, okay? And again, you can rename it anything. Now, I don't need this original Google Colab notebook anymore, so I'm gonna go ahead and close it. And now, if I make any changes, so let's say this is a new change, and I do Shift Enter, I can go ahead and do Control S to save it. So now this is being saved on my, this is my own version, and it can be saved on my Google Drive, okay? All right. So that's pretty much it. So this is how we can open a notebook. You can open notebooks from other people's GitHub, and or you can open notebook from your own Google Drive, right? So right now there is only one file here. And when you go to Google Drive, you should have access to that notebook, okay? So in the next video, I'm going to go ahead and review what we have here, what we can do in a notebook, and talk about different cells, different Python. Basically, here's a table of contents. How we can mount a drive, how we can mount a Google Drive in a notebook, and etc. Okay, so see you in the next one.